Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MoreShay with Marshay. Today's video is going to be 5 tips for teens. Okay, so today's video, I thought to give out some tips, some tools, some advice for our teenagers. There are so many teenagers out there. I know sometimes I act like an old lady, but I'm really young myself. I'm like 25 years old. So I'm young in heart, but I'm very mature in mind. And so I felt like there were some tips that I wanted to throw out there for teenagers, some things they've probably heard, but maybe not like this. And I just thought I'd share. So let's go. Number one. Now, depending on who you are, where you're from, your culture, your religion, your sex, your creed, your family's origin, your background, you may or may not have been given this type of advice, and you may or may not want to take heed to it. But the thing that I would say is get to know God for yourself. That's the number one tip that I would give any teenager. Why? And I'm not doing this. I'm not saying this out of religious reasons to try to convince you to believe in one religion. I'm not saying this to try to make you feel convicted in spirit to just hold on to one thing and to assume that that's the best thing for you. But the reason I am saying this is because any difficult moment I had, whether as a child, whether as a teen, all the way up until now as an adult and so forth and going on, so far, my number one resource, he's not even just the resource, because the resource is the tool to help you get to the source. He is the source. My number one source has been God, and I mean that with everything in me. I don't mean that off of no religious aspects. I don't mean that because my mother or my father taught me that. My parents didn't teach me religion. My parents didn't teach me to go to God. My parents didn't mention that to me. My grandmothers even did not mention that to me. They did not say, oh, go to God. Yes, one of my grandmothers went to church and took us to church with her plenty of Sundays and on holidays, etc. But I was not taught from a parent in a household that we're going to read the Bible at night. I was not taught that we're going to pray. I was not taught that when things get difficult, you go to God. I was not taught this thing from a family member, from a friend, nobody. I was taught this from my own spirit, my own heart feeling convicted. I heard about this man named Jesus. I heard about God. I was in church. And yes, I was listening. And of course, I was receiving the information from somewhere. But then I had the connection with him already instilled in me that I just had to build the relationship just to have the conversation with him. I literally was a kid talking to God. When things were difficult, he spoke to me. And so I say this like, I don't want you to think off of no weird, oh, it's going to be some voice that you've never recognized before. You will recognize God's voice. So oftentimes people are like, how do you know it's God? You're going to know. It's just like I tell people when it comes to your relationship, and they're like, how do you know if you're ready to get married? You're ready to get married. There's so many tools and tips to knowing if you are ready and prepared as a whole individual, whether financially, mentally, spiritually. I don't feel like going into all that, but it's so much that you have to be prepared for. But if we're talking about what your heart and your soul will feel, it will know without a doubt. It will not have to ask. It will not have to question. It will not have to wonder. It will know that when I wake up, I feel happy with this decision. I feel whole with this choice. So with God, it's the same thing. If God was to speak to you, when God speaks to you, you will know it's God. And yes, God can speak through other people. And when I say that, I mean, no, he's not always speaking through people. Sometimes he's speaking through things you hear, radio, television. Sometimes he's speaking directly in your ears. Sometimes he's speaking through the way things in your life move. And when it flows effortlessly, you start to see that this must be God. But he will also speak through people. Sometimes there are people that have conversations with you and they may say something. You may be like, hold on, why it sound like she know my business? And if there's somebody that don't know you that well or don't know your situation that well, it was God. God was speaking through them. He had a conversation for them to have with you for a reason. There was something you needed to hear. There was something you needed to see. Maybe it's this video. Like, I'm so serious when it comes to instilling God in people. If you don't like God, if you don't love God, if you're afraid of getting to know God, and if you don't, you're not even open-minded to the decision of God, maybe this isn't the channel for you, because I'm not gonna lie, his name will be mentioned. His name will be mentioned on this channel, and you know, I'm going to suggest as a number one tool or tip for any teenager. This is a difficult time for you. I already know it's going to be a difficult time throughout life. So many stages of life is just hard, it's good, it's bad, it's sad, it's mad, it's glad. It's like an up and down roller coaster every moment. You never know how things are going to turn out. But when you have God, there's a solid root, there's a solid foundation. And I don't say this off of no biblical standpoint because I'm not no Bible scholar. I don't say this, oh, because I was at church hollering and speaking in tongues, not saying anything is wrong with that, because I love that as well. I have no problem with the Bible, love that as well, all of that. I'm just saying this to say it's not religion for me, it's relationship for me. Really build that relationship with God. I would tell anybody that. If you were my own sister, my own cousin, brother, nephew, niece, and it was something that I couldn't help you with, that I couldn't understand, that I couldn't place my finger on, or you needed a question answered and none of us could figure it out and there were no resources around, I know the source has the answer, and his name is God. And if you ask him, it will start to flow, it will start to come to you. It will start to flow, it will start to come to you, whether it's the people you connect with, whether it's the places you start to be at. It's something that will automatically allow itself in your life if you just open that door. You have to be willing to allow it. You can't be afraid of that relationship, because it can be scary to many people when they feel God. It overwhelms you, it overwhelms your heart, and sometimes you're like, this is too much to handle and I don't want to deal with it. But it's the best thing for you. Honestly, it's the best thing for you. And when I say that, I mean that wholeheartedly. Just trust me if you can on this one thing. Trust me if you don't take no more advice from this video. That's the one thing I want you to take with you. Please, number one, get to know God for yourself. Not for what somebody taught you, not for what somebody told you about God. It's cool to have their advice and their knowledge about all of that, but it's even better to go to him, to get to know him, to speak to him, to read up on his word, to engage in activities or places or people that know more about him than you. It is so good to get to know God. That's number one. And I don't mean this with nothing trying to just convince you to go one lane. Whomever your God is, just serve him the best way you know how. Number one, get to know God. Okay. Sorry. Number two, the number two tip, tool that I would give any teen is to love yourself. Make yourself a priority. That's what I would say. Make yourself a priority. You are important and you come first. Now, after God, there comes you. After God, there comes you. So often in life, I don't know if you're a girl, female, woman like me, our innate behavior is telling us to put others first. It's telling us to nurture others, nurture the relationship with others, to the point where we forget about us, where we forget about who we are, how important we are. And we feel like, well, if I'm serving them, then I'm serving me well. Serve you well first. The reason Marshay, that's me, would even tell you that is because I haven't served me well plenty of times. I say this in videos and y'all might be thinking, why are you saying this? Like, you're just trying to be relatable. I'm not. I don't have no need to sit here and sell a story that's not mine. Like, I literally have not put me first plenty of times. I'm not going to lie. I've probably wanted to. I've probably thought that I should, or I probably thought that I did, but I didn't. I didn't put me first, because if I would have put me first, it's some decisions I would have not made. I would have said no to some things. I would have been like, no, that's not it for me. No, that doesn't serve me. No, I can't, with no explanation. If I was putting me first, I would have noticed the behavior of my life change. It would have been so many things that I've done for people that I wouldn't have. And not saying doing things for people is a bad thing. I'm just saying at times there were moments where I knew God probably told me I shouldn't have, but I did it anyway. There were so many times that I didn't choose me, whether it's in my health. I make bad eating decisions all the time. I know that's not putting me first, because if I loved me enough, I would choose to eat the best things for me and my body. No, I'm not perfect, but can I make a better decision? Yes. So again, I would tell you to put yourself as a priority. There's a book I read, and I think I mentioned in a video before, and it's called Women and Money by, oh my gosh, I can't remember her name. She's a popular financial advisor. She's a great woman. If I get the name, I'll definitely put it in the comments or the description. I can't think off the top of my head, but y'all probably know who I'm talking about. Blonde, short haircut. But she literally teaches you in the book how to say no. Women have such a difficulty with the relationship with money because of their lack of saying no. You know, I don't know if it's fearing us. I don't know if we feel like we are not supporting the ones we love. I don't know if it's that we don't know how to choose us, but we don't know how to say no enough. And no is such a powerful word. It's two letters. It's such a powerful word. So yes, number one, I would tell you, get to know God for yourself, not for who your sister told you God was, not for your aunt told you God was, not for who the church portrayed God as, but for who God is to you. Because he has a special relationship with you that's unlike any other. I'm telling you that because I know it for a fact, because I've experienced it, not because I heard it or I seen it or I thought it was something that I should know, but because I've experienced it. So number one, get to know God for yourself. Number two, make yourself a priority. If I could start my life back 10 years ago when I was 15, if I could start my life back to 14 or 13, I would hope that I could teach myself and tell myself, make yourself a priority, Marshay. I love people when I see them and they choose them and they be like, certain things that don't serve them or don't feel good to them or they don't want or they don't like, they know how to make it plain and say no. I know how to do it in certain areas, I'm not gonna lie. Certain things, it's just a plain no for me. I'm not doing it. But when it comes to some things, I'm not good at saying no. I'm not good at standing my ground. And so I just want you, if you could take any advice from this 25-year-old young woman who's still learning herself, is to make yourself a priority. Learn to say no. If it's not for you, don't do it. You don't have to. You really don't. You will still be just as great as you were before, even better for having the confidence to actually choose you first. I'm telling you, like, that overpowers me just hearing that. Please make yourself a priority. As young as you are special. You are kind. You are beautiful. You are smart. There is something about you that somebody will like. There is something about you that somebody will love. You don't have to chase him. You don't have to chase her. It's coming to you. It's already yours. Make yourself a priority. Number one, get to know God. Number two, make yourself a priority. Okay? I'm sorry. I need to lighten the mood in the room. Like, I feel like sometimes it's getting heavy. Whew. Okay. Number three, I want you to know that you take it each day, each moment, each step, each second at a time. I got this advice from J-Lo. Now, she didn't create this, of course, but J-Lo said this in an interview. I forgot what they asked her, but they was like, if it was one thing that you could tell yourself, your younger self, or teach your younger self, what would it be? And she said, take it each moment at a time. Take it each step, each day at a time. That advice has helped me so much because I'm the type of person where I'm always thinking about what's next. I'm always planning for what's to come. I'm always focused on, okay, I have to do this, and I'm goal oriented. So I have this schedule in my head and I feel like everything has to go in order and everything has to go right. And it's like, I'm always planning to continue, which is terrible because things will never be perfect. They will never go in a detail oriented schedule that you've planned so perfectly in your head. You literally can plan everything in the world and something will still come in that you least expect. So what I would say is not to not be organized or not to not plan or to not be focused or to not be goal oriented. Those can be positive traits, but don't drive yourself into overdrive. Literally allow yourself to feel each moment. Literally allow yourself to know that if it's bad now, it won't always be. Literally allow yourself to know that if it doesn't feel its best right now, right at this moment, right at this second, that doesn't mean that's going to last forever. This is just now. And if you give yourself a little bit of time to grow, a little bit of room, you'll see you'll be in a different place and you'll be in a happier space. I'm telling you, I know people say this all the time. Oh, it gets better. It doesn't rain forever. Tomorrow, the sun has to shine. And you hear all these quotes and you're like, oh God, I've heard that 1,000 times before. It doesn't feel good right now. What are you talking about? That's true. It doesn't feel good. You're right. And what happened? It ain't right. And sometimes the situation is not how it's supposed to be. And it doesn't look pretty and it doesn't feel good. You're right. You're right about that. But what I'm telling you is, if you take it each moment, each step at a time, if you really allow yourself the space to be like, okay, I'm gonna sit in this. I know it's bad now, but it ain't gonna always be bad. It does get better for real. They're not lying about that part. It really gets better. It really, really gets better. And especially when you get grown and you have choices and you have free will. And if you put in work and if you give yourself the space to learn and to grow and to do things in a different way, it literally gets better. It doesn't always have to be like it is. I promise you it doesn't. Because Marshay is the type of person, if things didn't look good and it didn't feel good and all of a sudden I started to overwhelm, my thoughts and my mind went into overdrive. But then as I got older and I realized some things I don't have control of, let it be, let it breathe, let it go. Just let it go. So number one, get to know God for yourself. Number two, make yourself a priority. Number three, like I was just saying, take it each moment, each step, each second at a time. Okay? Let it go. Just breathe. Just relax. And this goes into number four. Number four is have fun. Have fun meaning you won't always not have to pay bills. Sooner than later, there will be a time where you will have to pay bills, where you will have to worry about your children, where you'll have to worry about your husband or your wife or your spouse. There will be a time where you literally will have to worry maybe just about yourself and your neighbor. There will be a time where you have to worry about you and your roommate, or you'll have to worry about, did you make sure that you turned your alarm on at night or whatever, like whatever it is that your life consists of. There will be a time where there will be some things that are necessary, some things that are needed. Your mom will not make you breakfast every morning. Your mom will not lay out your uniform and iron it. Like, your mom will not be able to call the school and to let them know why this happened or when or what's going on. There will be a time where you'll have to do those things. There will be a time where you'll have to call for your kids or your neighbor's kids or your god kid or your aunt or whoever, or whatever your situation is. There will be a time when things won't be like they are. So I'm telling you, for the time being, have fun. Have fun. That's something I didn't do much. Like, let me stop lying. I had some fun. Like, I played outside, like you should. I played outside. I had cheerleading teams, and not a real cheerleading team, but, you know, one that we created, singing groups and, oh, printing out lyrics and playing house. And I had my times of fun. I'm not going to lie. I had some fun. So you need to have your fun. And I just feel like I didn't allow myself to be a kid at all times. There was a lot of times where I always made myself think like I was an adult, like I'm always thinking with a responsible mind. And it's like, yeah, you got to be responsible, be human. You don't want anything to just happen, but still let yourself have fun. Let yourself let loose every now and again. So now as an adult, I'm retraining my thought process. And the reason I'm leaning is because, like, I'm having a conversation with you. I'm having a conversation with you, and I'm really letting you know what I really feel in my heart. I had to allow myself to let some of my guards down. I had a lot of, I won't, I will never, I cannot, I am not. And then it's like, just as much as I had to learn to use the word no, I had to also allow myself to learn the word yes. That some things were okay. That sometimes you'll be imperfect, you'll flawed, you'll fail. Like, you know, I was really clumsy at times. Like, I'm not a clumsy person. Some may beg to differ, but I'm really clumsy at times, and I knock over drinks and I may fall. And it's like, it's God reminded me, you're human, Marshay, relax. Because sometimes when you're that overdrive personality where you're always thinking, how do I do this? And when do I do that? And I gotta do this and I gotta do that. That's great, Mrs. Parents. But at times that's not so good, because it's like, relax, sit back, kick your feet up. So I always do that. Now that I'm grown, I give myself the space to listen to my music, drink a little bit of wine and relax and dance around the room and exercise and then fall or do something stupid just to feel stupid. Like, you don't have to be on key, on point all the time. You ain't in front of a crowd performing and speaking. Like, sometimes you're alone, have that conversation, chill. You ain't got to say the right thing all the time, because this mouth, sometimes it says the wrong thing, and it's okay. You know, relax. So number four is to have fun. I'm telling you, like, literally have fun. Go play with your friends. Play with your friends. You're a teenager. Go hang with your friends. Go to the mall if that's what you want to do. It's COVID. Be safe. But at the same time, I mean, live. When I say live, go the places you want to go. See the things you want to see. Because this life is not promised to us forever. You don't know how long you're going to be here. You never know which day. And I hope you live forever. I wish. I send positive vibrations of life forever. But at the same time, we don't have no choice over this thing. So live. Allow yourself to breathe. Have fun, girl. I had to teach myself how to have fun again. Like, I knew how to have fun as a kid and as a teen when I wasn't thinking too hard at times. And then there were those times I was in overdrive. And then I had to be an adult where it was like, okay, now I'm grown, so I gotta do this. But then I had to tell myself, girl, just because you're doing this don't mean you still can't relax. You have to relax, because if not, you would drive yourself crazy. Relax, it will be okay. Tell your parents. I know some of them parents over there driving you crazy, thinking everything has to be perfect and everything has to go right. You are human, meaning you're gonna make some mistakes, you're gonna be a little flawed, and it is okay. And even if you think you're not making a mistake, you are. Being perfect is a mistake. If nobody never told you before, it is a mistake. It is not the right way to go. Perfect is boring, like they say. And I hope y'all can't see my little ooh girl, like I'm too close up in the camera, ain't even watching. But no, seriously, I'm so serious. Have fun. So number four was have fun. Number three was to, what did I say? Number three was? Let me go from one. One is to get to know God for yourself. Number two is make yourself a priority. Number three was to, what did I say? Oh, take it each day, each moment, each step at a time. Number four is to have fun. Have fun, let loose, let it be a little messed up. Let yourself make a mistake, it is okay, okay? Number five. Now this one you may not wanna hear, you might be like, girl, okay, turn this off. Number five, listen to your trusted loved one. If it's a parent that you trust and you have a close relationship with, say your mom is your best friend, say your grandfather is your best friend, say your grandmother or your aunt or your cousin or your niece or whoever it is that you're really, really close to, that you really, really love, that you trust, that's a little bit older than you, that may be way older than you, that are grown, let them give you advice and take heed to it. Some of the things they say, not everything, because they think everything they say, not everything, but some of the things they say is really good for you. It's really good for you. It really will help you. And it really is a positive benefit to your life. They are not lying. They are really trying to help you. And sometimes they may not have all the answers. Sometimes they are wrong. Sometimes things did change. It is a different generation. Times have changed. But sometimes they are right. I'm not going to lie. Your parents are right. Some of the things they tell you, they mean it out of love. And they're really trying to protect you. And they're really trying to keep you safe. And they're trying to make sure you don't make the mistakes they did, because I'm trying to make sure you don't make them ones I did. Like, I don't want you to be an uptight, I can't fail, like I'm perfect type of person. I don't want that with any of my videos. Please don't think I'm trying to train you to be perfect, because you could never be perfect. There's not enough training in the world to prepare you for perfection. That is something I could never do. I'm not even there. So how could I tell you? You can't train to be perfect. You could just train to be the best person that you can and try to do better each day and try to live and love better. And I'm sorry if I'm talking too much. I ramble. But really, I'm going to go over these five tips again, because I need you to take heed to these teenagers, whomever you are. I mean this with love. I don't have a negative bone in my body towards whomever you are or to try to send you the wrong way. I'm trying to give you the best advice that I can. Like on this channel, we're going to give you some positivity, some love, some light, and some fun. We're gonna talk our entertainment, we're gonna talk our music and our media. And I hope y'all heard that Tory Lanez was arrested, and I still don't know the full story when it comes to that situation with him and Meg Thee Stallion. But I do believe in my heart, I can't say this, but allegedly that he shot her. But at the same time, I do believe there was some wrong done on both parts. I'm not saying she's wrong for getting shot. I mean, like, what I'm saying is something probably happened, an argument or whatever, but it, no woman deserves to be shot. I don't care what nobody say. Like, some people like, oh, she did this. I don't care what she did. Nobody deserves to be shot, and no woman deserves to be shot by no man, period, point blank. And I love his music, and it's sad that he has to go out like this, but I can't support you. It's just like R. Kelly. I don't want to bring this up. Like, I wasn't a huge R. Kelly fan, because that's not my generation, but I actually liked his songs. I actually liked his music until I heard in depth what he did to those girls. It was over for me. Now I try to play the music, and I was like, all right, I'm gonna try to separate the music from the man. And then I couldn't. It just didn't feel good. Even when I heard it, it felt nasty. I started feeling like somebody was being kidnapped and held against their will and not able to use the bathroom and not eat, allegedly. Like, that stuff was killing my mind. I couldn't even do it. So I'm telling you, Tory Lanez, it's gonna be the same thing. Like, even if I was to try to play your music, I can't play it comfortably, because now I feel like you shot a black woman, and that feels like I've been shot. Like, I don't like it. I have a distaste in my mouth for you. It's not good. But yeah, I don't know why I mentioned that, but back to the topics at hand. I'm gonna give you the five tips again, just so you could take them home with you, write them down, put them in your journal, pray on them, whatever you want to do. Number one, get to know God for yourself. Number two, make yourself a priority. You matter, girl. Number three, take it each day, take it each moment, each step at a time. Relax, let yourself breathe. It's gonna be all right. Number four, have fun. If you don't do nothing else in this lifetime, have some fun. Smile a little, laugh a little, make a little mistake, say whatever you want, be a little, you know, you can do what you want. I mean, not all the time, be safe, but have fun. Okay, have some fun. Number five, what did I just tell y'all? Oh yeah, take heed to your parents or whomever that older adult is in your life that you love advice. They mean you well. They really do. Okay, so that's about it. That's our 5 tips, tools, and signs and help and advice for you teenagers out there. I mean this with love. I hope you all go out there and you do well with that. Whatever it is that you want to do with your life, I'm getting tongue-tied. Whatever it is that you want to do with your life, do it and do it well. You got this. It's going to be all right. All right? I'm here for you if not. And feel free to comment below. Feel free to like this, share this, all of that. Love y'all. Till I talk to you soon. This is MoreShay with Marshay. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell y'all. So you see how my shirt say, girl, you are the boss. Girl, if you don't know already, you are the boss. You are the boss of your life. You are the boss of your mind. You are the boss of you, your body. You control you. Don't nobody else have allegiance to who you are. You get to choose how this life is lived out. Now, God, he's there. He's doing his job. He's doing the behind the scenes work, the work that you don't even see being done. But girl, you are the boss. Okay. You are not the boss's assistant. You are not the boss's maid. You are the boss. Signed, Marshay.